In this video, we will describe performance analytics dashboards and show you how to create a dashboard. The page you see when you log in to a ServiceNow instance displays widgets that provide visualizations of data. For example, the self-service page provides a variety of visualizations related to self-service options. Performance analytics dashboards are very similar in that they provide an entry point for performance analytics users to view data. A dashboard shows the most relevant indicators for specific users or groups divided into tabs to logically group widgets that belong together. For our first dashboard, we want to display a wide variety of indicators related to analyzing the optimum number of staff on duty to handle incidents, problems, and changes. We'll name our new dashboard Staff Optimization Monitor to summarize the data it will display. The Order field indicates where the dashboard appears in the menu. You can always adjust this number later. If you want to use a breakdown source, you can indicate that here. We'll learn about using a breakdown source for a dashboard in the next video in our series, so for now, we'll leave the checkbox unselected for this example. You can control the visibility of the dashboard by making it visible only to users with required roles, or you can make it visible only to specific groups or users. We want our dashboard to be visible to the entire company, so we'll change the Visible To setting back to Everyone. When we add the dashboard, one tab labeled Home appears. For our example, we want to display incident, problem, and change data separately, so we'll rename the default tab Incident Staffing and add two more tabs. Here, you can either add a tab or link an existing tab to this dashboard. We'll add a tab and name it Problem Staffing. The third and final tab will cover Change Staffing. Now we can start adding visualizations, or widgets, to the dashboard. In the Add Content pane, the Performance Analytics category is selected by default in the first search block. In the second search block, we can select the type of content, which will populate the third list of available scorecards. The first widget we'll add will be a score. When we select the scorecard, we click on a tile to indicate where we want it to display, and it appears on the page. We'll continue adding content until the tabs are populated with relevant scorecards. When we point to the top right of each widget, we can access more options. We can edit any aspect of the widget, including the type, visualization, display settings, access settings, and date settings. We can also refresh the data displayed in the widget. We can edit the appearance of any widget as well, including the border, title, alignment, and font size. We can also view the widget description. And if we change our mind about adding the widget, we can just close the widget and it disappears. Now we've added all the data we need for this dashboard. At this point, you may want to change the layout to best display the widgets on the page. In the next video in this series, we will show you how to create your first breakdown dashboard, using the breakdown we created in the previous video in this series, Create Your First Breakdown. For more information, please consult our product documentation or knowledge base, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.